What it do? What it do? YouTube.
Let me know. Let me know. Let me know. Let me know if you're comfortable.
My 2K21 not clear.
I found your vibe, and I found my. Yeah. Let's touch the sky. I'ma change your life. Yeah. Do you realize I love the way you look me in my eyes? Yeah. Don't kill my vibe. Don't kill my vibe, yeah. On top of my game, we are the same, ay. I wonder why lame think that they run things. I wonder why, I wonder why, yeah. Just feel the vibes, just.
There we go. My bad. But, first down, get to it. First down. He playing the Pelicans. We at home. We gonna go with this. We gonna do this one. We got another thing on the channel, American Truck Simulator.
Black Frank White, how you doing, man?
I'm good, man. Always good to be on NBA 2K TV. How's everything?
Everything is great, you know.
And I will be putting another GTA video up.
And the player introductions are wrapped up. The starting fives for both teams. And welcome, everybody, to another presentation of the NBA Live. Now, the opening lineup for the New Orleans Pelicans. We got Bledsoe. He's out there with J.J. Redick. Adams is out there with Hart. And it's Melly in at the four-man position. And for the Grizzlies, Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Junior's out there with Morant. And it's Anderson in at the three spot. Now, here's Redick. D right on him. Lock at six. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on John Morant. That's his first foul.
Kind of a ticky-tack foul there, but you have to be aware that's how the refs are going to blow.
I even touch him for it. You're right.
Blow the whistle tonight.
Pass to Melly. Five to shoot. New Orleans needs to get off a shot. Cloak loose. Redick with it. Now guarded by Redick. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. And so here's Memphis. Junior, the pass to Valanciunas. Shoots over Adams, and the shot is long. And here's Redick. He'll bring it up for the Pelicans. Last game matched up with the Clippers. A tough loss there.
And the fact they still had a chance to win that game, I find to be somewhat amazing, because it was clearly an off night for most of their guys.
I'll tell you, if they had pulled that game out, it would have been an amazing win, because they made a bunch of mistakes, nothing was going their way, and somehow they still nearly won it.
Memphis shooting their initial free throws of the game right here.
Really, they haven't been able to differentiate themselves from the free throw line on the season at about 76%.
So he hits one of two from the stripe. Valanciunas trying to free himself up. Count the basket.
A little breakdown there, letting them get that rebound. You can't allow that to happen.
Morant against Bledsoe. And the jam by Bledsoe.
Once Bledsoe gets ahead of steam and gets those feet together, you get plays like that.
And Eric Bledsoe, a special kind of athlete.
And three separate knee surgeries in the rear view, but still so fast, his teammates call him Ferrari. The way he's built, a muscle car might be more accurate.
Adams dishes to Redick. Jackson kicks to Morant. A putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
Here's Bledsoe. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Clippers.
Lest us not forget about the work on the glass. His effort level was a 10 that night out of 10.
Grizzlies with the rebound. Coming into this, having notched a win against Cleveland in their last game.
Yeah, let's give a shout out to their defense in that one. The intensity, the shot blocking, just a dominant performance.
Yeah, last game was pretty impressive stuff on that end of the floor, just getting up near shooters and blocking as many shots as they did.
Junior with it, now guarded by Bledsoe. Valanciunas, good.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
And so it's Bledsoe. He brings it up for New Orleans. They trail by 7. And this is the first season matchup for them against the Grizzlies.
Two division rivals facing off tonight. They'll see one another 4 times this season.
Unloads from 13. No good off the back of the rim.
Nobody getting a hand in his face in that painted area. That's a miss he's going to be disappointed with. He'll have a hard time shaking that one off. Perfect position. Plenty of space, just clanked it. He's very smart about spotting up in transition, and no one rotated over to contest that one.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Well, Kevin, I did have a chance to speak with Stan Van Gundy. I asked him about the task of slowing down Ja Morant. The coach said the one thing you can't account for with Morant is his explosiveness. Everything else you can plan for, but sometimes he'll just beat you. And Kevin, that's what they mean when they say good defense, better offense. Back to you.
Thank you, David. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Morant is out there with Junior, and it's Anderson in at the small forward position. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. Pelicans trail by 8. And Redick, here we go. Outside for Bledsoe. They get it back, and it's Adams on the follow.
And Steven Adams just a wrecking ball down there with his size and strength in the offensive glass.
Morant outside. Pass to Junior.
Yes, sir. Get it up.
And it's Melly with the rebound. The Pelicans have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. Redick passes to Melly. Out to the wing. Bledsoe against Morant. 6 on the shot clock. A nice shot by Melly.
Again, floor vision from Eric Bledsoe makes dishing that basketball look easy.
And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Break the 2 words you and I don't like the most in this game, load management. Why do we see more of it now than when you played in the game?
A couple of things. I think sports science has evolved, and I've talked to a ton of coaches about this. The reality is that now they don't determine whether or not a guy's going to play. It's going to be the people that work with the strength and conditioning. They determine if a guy is ready to go. Secondly, I would also say the contracts now, the investments that teams have in these assets, you want to try to prolong their careers as long as possible. And so I think it's a smart move from an investment standpoint.
You bring up some great points. And trying for the go-ahead basket, it doesn't go in. Anderson passes to Junior. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. 3 trips to the line so far for him in this one.
Numbers this year at the line below 70. So when he's getting to the line, not nearly as effective as he'd like. As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
Pass to Melly. To the wing right side. Here's Hart, guarded by Jackson. Stolen by Jackson. By himself. And Junior throws it down.
Anderson has great vision as a point forward. Exceptional court awareness.
Pelicans trail by 6. Now here's Redick. Last time, 14 points for him. Adams. misses in close.
And, they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus five in that category.
Morant passes to Valanciunas.
And have to commend the unselfish attitude. Like how Morant just recognized the open man and the ball was right there.
And here's Bledsoe. He's been playing a big part of their offensive scheme, averaging around 15 and a half points a game.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
This is his first free throw of the game. And so it's the Memphis Grizzlies ahead. Happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation. And the Grizzlies leading by nine. Checking out the group for Stan Van Gundy to start the second half. J.J. Redick is out there at Bledsoe. And then there's Steven Adams. And it's Melly in at power four.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
New Orleans has gone 5-9 when they put up a three-point shot tonight. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, thanks very much. Well, Steven Adams could be the league's most physical presence. All-star Jimmy Butler said that he is just so strong. Butler says he hit me with a screen, and I thought my life was over. Adams said his strength doesn't help with flopping. Refs are like, get up. Guys, he has a sense of humor about it, and maybe that's a counterbalance to his great physical gifts.
You're right, D.A. He is strong. Thanks for that report. Now Bledsoe, 6 points for him. Adams dishes to Redick, and the foul called on Junior. That's foul number two for him. Bledsoe with it. And he converts the layup. Bledsoe's got his third bucket of the night.
Tough to match up with Eric Bledsoe. He's incredible at slicing up the D, especially using the bounce.
Jackson passes to Junior. The Grizzlies shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. First one falls for him.
Two shots.
He doesn't get the second one. Pelicans trail by seven. It seems like every team break needs that one, that one guy who's going to get under opponent's skin.
Well, in one poll of coaches and players, Adams was voted the second dirtiest player in the league. One guy said he's real physical, but maybe he crosses the line. Throws the sneaky elbow here and there, commits extra hard fouls, yet Adams usually escapes foul trouble.
Just five to shoot. Bledsoe dishes to Redick. Hart the pass to Bledsoe.
D giving him that shot, and that's probably not a good idea, but I guess they knew what they were doing that time.
Jackson trying to break free. And it's Junior missing.
Not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
Redick passes to Bledsoe.
Yeah, that's got them over the limit with a lot of time still left. They're going to have to tone it down, or they may end up giving up a lot of free throws here.
He's made two of his three attempted tonight. Good on both.
He's just such a bulldog out there in terms of his mentality. Eric Bledsoe can get assertive, and when he does that, it raises the level of play for the entire team.
Pelicans trail by seven. Side Redick from downtown hits it from three-point range. Redick's got five now.
That's three of four here to start the half.
Morant kicks to Anderson. Here's Junior shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. Steven Adams picks one up. He's gone 5 of 8 free throw shooting in the game. Jackson A's, he's checked in for New Orleans. Lonzo Ball comes in for J.J. Redick.
and one of the more unsung players included in the Anthony Davis trade. Josh Hart just continues to impress when given the opportunity.
A very much high character, hardworking player, and a lot more substance to his game. I also think it's interesting that in that deal, he came along with Lonzo Ball. So the two of them together accepting this new opportunity within the same roles.
Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Junior's out there with John Morant, and it's Anderson in at the three. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. Shot's good by Bledsoe.
Bledsoe loving to take on this challenge here, not fearing getting hit on the way up.
Morant passes to Jackson. Junior kicks to Anderson. Morant with it, now defended by Adams. Six to shoot. Here's Valanciunas, and it's Valanciunas finishing it off.
And one way Valanciunas generates offense, using that big body to snare the board and keep the play alive.
Morant against Bledsoe. It's good. Bledsoe's got 13 points here in the second half alone.
Maybe the halftime break was good for him, allowed him to step back, calm himself down, get himself in the right frame of mind, and now shots are falling. Been a struggle for him tonight, but if they can make this lead hold up, they can just chalk this up as one of those nights.
Morant drives in, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Absolutely fearless. Morant willing to put his body on the line in order to make plays.
Hart, he's checked in for New Orleans.
And they didn't shoot it very well from the line in the first half, but they've gotten much better since halftime, and it's helped them to secure the lead.
Redick surveying the D. Bledsoe outside. Here's Adams, and that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And Jackson throws it down.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying to get back into a game like this.
Ouch, Greg, that is definitely an emphasis jam. A big apostrophe or exclamation point, maybe even a question mark. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And how about the body control? Morant, even when under duress, stays calm, cool, and collected.
Here's the lob to Adams. The shot comes out.
And that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
Yeah, you can see when it's that close, players react. He goes, oh, man, we just missed that one. Maybe they'll get another chance at it.
And he gets the bucket.
Sweet to be a difference maker in the game, and he's been a great option for them on these possessions.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
And now, a moment to present the New Balance player of the game, Jaren Jackson.
And his percentage from the field tonight seems almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
He's played up to his full potential tonight, and he's been playing to the crowd, too. He loves being the star attraction, even if it doesn't happen on a regular basis. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alder.
Hey, Kevin, during the last break, I heard Stan Van Gundy as he talked with his team. He got on him. He said he's got to see more intensity. He said we put ourselves in this hole, and we've got to work our way out of it. Show me you've got what it takes. Guys.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going. Eric Bledsoe steps up in a big moment.
Anderson outside. Here's Valanciunas. Lays it up off the glass. Valanciunas has got six here in this quarter.
But he seems to be in the right place at the right time more often than anybody that's on the court here tonight. We see that pay off.
Another shot. Adams' shot is off. And the Grizzlies leading by 7. Pass to Junior. Some nice passing there by Memphis. It's good.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
Redick with the bucket.
The defense had better put J.J. Redick on a leash and trail him around. He's ready to fire as soon as he gets that ball.
Anderson passes to Junior. And the Grizzlies get it back. Valanciunas, good.
You don't want to ever give up points on the boards. That's the lesson for the team there. That's a hustle play to save points.
Bledsoe against Morant. Bledsoe outside. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Eric Bledsoe says pressure. What pressure? Take that.
Free throw drops for Eric Bledsoe. And the Grizzlies leading by 5 to the left side wing. On the arc. They get it back. Jackson. And Adams sends it back.
And Steven Adams just throwing that one out of the way.
And 101 left in the fourth. And there's the pass to Junior. Valanciunas dishes to Anderson. Clock at 4. He feeds it to Junior. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. Now, here's Morant for 3.
It's good patience from Bledsoe. Good job of contesting the shot and just making sure that the shooter feels it.
The shot by Redick, no good. And here's Morant. He'll bring it up for Memphis. They've led by as many as 11 points. And it's Junior missing.
Well, after an impressive first half, he's just not been able to get the room or get anything going here in the second.
Yes!
An aggressive Eric Bledsoe is a better Eric Bledsoe for this team.
And an intentional foul right there.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game.
That's the first. That gives them a 4-point cushion. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 5-point game.
And just like that, this game is a two-possession affair.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans. They're trailing by 5. 20 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Score, then hope for some missed free throws or a turnover at the other end.
Yeah, this won't be easy, so a little bit of luck will go a long way for them to get back in.
Here's Bledsoe. It's in! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within 3.
Wow, the energy from Bledsoe in this one, excelling at turning on the jets and getting to the basket.
And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul. Good on the first, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 5-point game.
And as good as Morant's been, there's still plenty of upside. One of the younger players to enter the draft in 2019.
And this is what dominating the glass looks like. He just cannot be contained.
Sort of reminding me of a little Ben Wallace action here from his years with the Pistons. He's been that much of a force rebounding the ball.
Second one is good. Being both at the line, and it's a 7-point game. Redick inside the line. No good. So it's Memphis picking up the win. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans, but in the end, everyone satisfied.
I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on, but let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And that about wraps it up. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. We'll see you next time.